There's something and back into the wild. Do
before going after that last shard.
That's Zia detected. Nice. The Ura launched their assault investment from this outpost. Zia must be there.
Zulten's Hollow is the Ura's border blockade. At least it used to be.
Man, you guys. Borders and walls and distrust. Of course, you never got to be friends.
Well, now it's personal, ain't it?
Oh, that must be that new weapon. Whatever that thing is supposed to be.
It's personal for him, and it's personal for me. He gets his hands.
It's
on
a rocket launcher. It's a freaking rocket launcher.
It's a little something I've been fixing up in my spare time.
Yeah, yeah. The fuck is that? It's a good goddamn
the
rocket launcher, though.
To keep the calamity from spreading through Zulten's Hollow. They got their own security and everything. Pretty fancy. Still, they ain't used to having visitors around. They've got these conductors that are all what's keeping the place together.
So I break these things and the whole place starts falling apart? We're just gonna do that to them? Come on, guys. We're never gonna be friends like this. Well, that's that something wrong stuff. Oh. Okay. Does not break easily.
Those rocks are like tumors. The same kind the Ura planted in Bastion.
You guys still sleeping? Now I can break them. Okay.
Break enough of those things, and the Calamity Rocks slink back into the ground.
Stop making me kill these people. I don't like it. Man. It hurts.
Well, the Ura must be in a panic right about now.
As cool as this gun is, not really a big fan.
Kid's done using the Calamity power for now. But the Ura ain't finished. They even sick their little rattletail pets on the kid. Those rodents are just a bump in the road.
Okay, I should definitely have kept an actual gun for this, I think. I have to go back and switch weapons. Because just trying to get the memorial thing is not enough of a reason to have this fire bellows. It's not that good of a weapon. For me, anyway. I mean, you guys may feel otherwise, and that's fine, but not my first choice. Break these now?
Kids picking the whole place apart.
Nope. Okay, it just moves. Yeah, I know, but I don't want to. Here to the terminals must know he's in town.
Kid returns their greeting tenfold.
I don't want. Whoa, stink eye maker thing.
They're easy targets.
Thank you.
onto the barricade. After all, their homeland's not much farther.
Oh, level up, nice. Also, I thought this was, like, not the way to go, but then the other place, or other way, totally... Oh, wait, hang on, this is blocked off. Now I have to go back the other way, okay. I know I have to break those.
Those calamity rocks must be eating that place apart from the inside.
Also, is that seriously what we're calling them? Just calamity rocks? It's kind of lazy. Am I seriously getting more money just based off of how much of this place I wreck also? Because that's kind of shitty. For them, I mean, but... What was back this way? Was it just a shortcut back to where I was? I think so. Yeah. That would explain it. Alright, motor on. Motor in.
Some of them are downright bewildered by what's happening.
Sorry, people. Like, I am genuinely feeling bad about this.
Maybe
it just
they
seems
know they lost this.
Like I'm it feels like I'm the bad guy now. And I'm pretty sure that I am, which sucks.
They underestimated. This may go wrong. Yes, our people caused the calamity, but here we are trying to fix it.
Well, yeah, but they don't trust you, and that's your fault. You know what? I need a turret. Help me out here, buddies. That is probably the best skill of any I've seen in this entire game. Just poop turrets.
Shame the opportunity for civilized discourse is over.
Again, our fault.
Suppose old Zulf should have got to know us better.
Yes. We blew you up, and then you didn't want to get to know us. Oh, you're so terrible and unreasonable. Come on, Rux. Is it really so unreasonable to think that, you know, almost killing their entire species would maybe not make them like you?
They have every reason to be angry.
Thank you.
Beyond angry.
I do not like these laser fucking turrets also, they're a real pain in the ass.
But when this is all over, it'll all be water under the bridge.
Yeah, because they'll all be dead at this fucking rate. I'm plowing through them, I'm gonna kill all of them.
Maybe I should have trusted him. Told him everything I knew.
Maybe you should have.
As the hour grows desperate, they are bringing out their big guns.
I mean, sure, but I have a mortar thing, which is a bigger gun than they have, so... Ow.
There's nothing standing in his way no more. He sees the Tazal terminals loom large on the horizon.
Found a child's drawing, just to rub it in a little bit more that I'm a
way
total fucking monster.
On the edge of the world, that's where he finally finds you.
So what is he talking to Zia?
But it ain't like Prosper Bluff this time.
Okay.
Ain't nothing for this gal to sing about now.
Yeah, because this is sad. What's up,
Zia? You weren't kidnapped.
Oh.
No, ma'am. You just had to see what happened to the Ura. To your own people.
Man. Okay, so she went to see them and come back to see us. She's really the one caught in the middle of this more than anybody.
To you was true.
She has their heritage, but she was raised by the Ceylandians' rules and customs, so she's caught right in the middle. That must really suck. Her guitar. And pardon me, miss, does this belong to you?
Sure you didn't drop that twangy thing on purpose, just to see if he'd go after you.
And the drawing.
They lost everything, didn't they? But they just keep on fighting like that's gonna bring it all back.
Well, you can't really blame them to be, that they're a little bit desperate. I mean, really. All right, Rux. Any more cryptic shit to tell me about?
I don't need to see what happened to the Ura. I'm trying to undo it. Remember?
Yeah, I guess. Man.
Once the kid gets that last shard from Zulf, it'll all be over.
One more training ground. I'm just gonna do that. Ooh, wow. Tazal terminals. All right, well, I'm gonna do this Mancer Observatory ground quickly, just off screen. I'll be back for you guys in a second. Really want to get this finale'd. All right, well, I couldn't quite manage to finish that one, so I'll figure that one out later. But for now, let's get on to the Tazal terminals to find Zulf. He bides his time within the remains of the Ura's massive underground sprawl.
The Tazal terminals. Ooh. All that's left of the Ura civilization. And the last stop on his little journey.
Well, let's go see our once friend, shall we?
No telling where the kid is now.
Okay, the Tazal terminals, here we are.
But he'll be alright.
I hope so.
Just needs to get that shard from Zulf and come on home.
Well, I mean, at least our task is fairly simple. I just wish we didn't have to do it.
The terminal's hardest of all.
Well, I mean, wasn't that the whole point of your weapon? To, you know, kill?
You know why Zulf went back there.
It's his home. Yeah. Come on, man. Everyone wants to go home.
All his friends and family were there. Taken by the calamity. Zulf must be there all alone, just waiting.
Doesn't seem very alone to me. Who the hell am I fighting if he's alone?
You know what's funny?
There's a lot of people with swords, man.
Well.
No, I don't know what's funny, Rux. I'm kind of busy right now. No time for us.
I'm waiting for a kid.
Yeah, haha, very funny. I don't see the point. I don't get it. Your jokes suck, man. Sorry.
Look around. There's not much left to do here in the Bastion, I'm afraid.
Yeah.
So why not tell each other stories to pass the time, right?
It's interesting that, like, he's been talking to Zia this whole time, though. Like, telling her about the kid and everything else. Doesn't really matter, I guess, but it's an interesting touch that he's talking to her instead of the audience. Sort of like
Zia,
preserving...
There's another reason I've been telling you all this.
Preserving the fourth wall instead of breaking it.
When the kid brings back that shard, the Bastion will be complete. What happens to Zulf will no longer matter.
That's a lot of shit happening! Oh my god! Fucking fuck, hold still. Nah. Too much shit happening at once. Everyone needs to calm the fuck down. Thank you.
This disease the Ura planted here will go away.
Just like magic, or what? This whole fix Bastion, fix everything is awfully convenient.
Ceylandia will be whole again. Everything will be back to normal.
Also, I think this mortar is my favorite thing of all time. It is saving my ass really, 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 really effectively.
Everyone will be alright.
I was gonna say really a lot, but then my brain was like, no, man, that's not English.
Problem is,
Whee!
we'll all be gone.
Wait, what? So, wait, whoa, so fixing the Bastion will just erase everything? Like, pull a hard reset? What? Or is this just, like, glass the planet?
We're not gonna die.
No.
It's more like...
Yeah, hard reset, then. Coming through?
All of this will just... stop.
Oh. So it's a time thing? Man, I'm confused. Just get back to me when you stop talking in riddles.
Things will go back to the way they used to be.
Yeah, it's a time thing, okay.
That's the power of the Bastion.
It's a reset button.
This whole place is a living record of the times before the Calamity.
The way
things were before this story.
Because of the crystals, of course. They're alive, they have memories. So by powering the Bastion with these crystals, it has all of those that's cool! It's actually kind of a cool thing. And I hop now instead of rolling. I mean, sure, why not?
Your old self again. Think of all those times that didn't go your way.
Whoops. Holes in the floor. But wait, that means they'll lose all the things they've experienced up to now, which, I mean, a lot of it has been sucky. You know, it's been pretty shitty, but, like, they'll forget each other. It's kind of sad. Guys, you need to stop standing still so much.
Setbacks. Imagine if you could have another go at him.
I mean, some of that would be good, but other things not so good. If you could try again with the memory of them, then I'd say fine, because you learn from those kind of things. But if it's just you forget everything, you know, go do it again, then you probably would end up making the same mistakes anyway.
Mistakes.
Man, that's not how you live.
Anyone you've ever heard?
It's an appealing notion to Rux, I'm sure, considering he, you know, unleashed the entire calamity on the Ura.
Everything you've ever done.
You take it back.
You could do it over. And wouldn't that be grand?
I mean,
wouldn't you agree?
Has its perks, certainly, but I still think it's a dangerous idea. Well, not dangerous so much as just kind of a bad idea.
I guess there's nothing more to say.
Oh, I'm just going up here, okay. Oh, this is a boss fight arena if I've ever seen one. Just have to fight smart, right? Oh, nice counter. Where did he go?
Who am I kidding?
I don't know. Who are you kidding? You kidding the kid? Guys? Now what? Wait, look, all of that was for one boss? One dude? Man, that's not worth it.
There's something else. A confession.
Shit. Ow. Okay, a confession. We kind of already knew you had one of those. You were feeling pretty guilty.
I know so much about the Bastion.
Well, you said you built it. You told us you did. In that who knows where place. You helped build it.
Well, I designed the place. But that's beside the point.
Oh. Okay. What is the point, then?
There's one problem with a place that sets things back to a bygone time. Can't test it.
Okay. Are you saying that you did test it?
So you're probably wondering if the calamity happened already.
Why didn't you change it?
What's to stop it from happening again after the Bastion does its thing?
Oh. I mean, I guess there's that too.
The answer is
cliffhanger.
I don't know.
Oh. I mean, okay. Yeah, Ven. Yeah, I figured that's who it was, or her, Zia's father. Poor guy had a bit of a raw deal.
You're wondering if there ain't some other way out of this mess. It's all right. I can tell.
Yeah, I mean, that's kind of what I've been saying.
But why would you even want another way? Unless...
Wait, two switches?
Unless you wanted to stay here with us.
I mean, you know, moving forward is not always a bad thing. But I get the feeling I'm gonna have like a multiple ending situation coming up anytime now.
Well, that's sweet and all, but I don't know if I can stick around.
Why, too guilty? Kind of a weak reason, honestly. Why, bull guy? Battering ram.
The weight of the calamity.
Yo, I can lift that!
It's on our shoulders.
Oh.
We can't just let it go.
Bring it! Holy shit! All the power.
Bastion does have another function, strictly speaking.
And what might that be? Whoa, the skill is awesome.
The monument blew out, and we couldn't repair it. We could still evacuate.
So, like, leave the Bastion, or does the Bastion itself move?
First, we'd round up as many folks as we could carry.
Okay. Can we go any faster, please? Holy
next,
shit.
We detonate the cores, and we take off away from here.
Oh, so it can move. That's pretty cool. God damn, this thing is slow. I mean, I'm not exactly a spry mover as it is normally, but this thing, I can't even roll around. Take me places.
Of course, that would mean no going back. Ever. But then again, that way, all of us could leave the city.
You know, start fresh.
Together.
Yeah. I mean, that doesn't sound so bad, really. I mean, sure, everyone is still dead, but like you said, there's no way of knowing it wouldn't happen again anyway, and...
You know, Zulf and his countrymen won't be giving up that shard without a fight, don't you?
Yes, I do. That's what I brought this for. Oh, the thing is so slow. I'm just gonna counter block stuff because I can't walk to them fast enough. You know what? Here, I fixed it.
Zulf and the Ura, all they want now is to see the Bastion fall.
We can't have that. Man, this whole end chapter is just sad.
Rest in peace between the Ura and Ceylandia.
Just like Zulf is mad, so they're mad, and like maybe they don't need to be as mad because they could fix it, but I don't know. Like I'm sure they'd push for the whole cosmic redo option. Holy crap, that hurts. Stop that. But like, I'm sure the Ura and Zulf would be fine with the cosmic redo option, but really it doesn't solve the problem.
Zulf ain't lost every shred of decency, though, has he?
Knock it off, laser turret. I'm trying to get to you. Thank you.
He tried to warn you about his plans. He tried to warn the kid.
Yeah, he did do that, didn't he? Next customer. Do I have to fight all of you? Can I not just leave? I'm getting so tired of this crap. This thing is so slow. Can I put it down? Okay, this is just tedious. Give me the thing.
Resolve this enemy.
Get back here and give me the thing. Yeah, shoot your buddy in the butt.
It ain't a simple matter of pride either.
I will just keep shaking and quaking until you guys give me what I want. Move over, Pith. I'm taking this shard.
One thing's for sure. The Ura can't be happy that the kid followed Zulf all the way home.
Yeah. Like a lost puppy. Is this where I'm going? No, it's not. Where am I going? I don't know. This way, finally, okay. Can I just... I need to get rid of this battering ram, please. This is Agate. Wait, they're fighting each other now. What the hell? Oh, they were beating up on Zulf. The hell? Choose. Move on. Abandon Zulf's body and press forward with the battering ram. Zulf's situation is hopeless and a distraction. His plan to avenge the Ura only brought more suffering. All that matters is a safe return of the shard. Or, take Zulf. Abandon the battering ram and pick up Zulf's body instead. Zulf is badly injured but breathing. It appears his countrymen turned on him as their situation grew desperate. He nearly destroyed the bastion, and yet... Oh, I don't know, man. This guy definitely fucked up, and I mean, he was angry and he was upset, and he didn't understand the context, I guess, of what was written in the journal, because it was written by Zia's dad, who was mighty bitter at the city, so he could have probably skewed the details a bit. But, like, wrecking the bastion, not even asking us to explain, sicking his countrymen on us, I mean, you know, kind of a dick move. But at the same time, just leaving him here to die is pretty shitty, and we do have the ability to fix this. I mean, I suppose if we're going to reset time, we can leave him here because it won't matter. I mean, it's going to reset, nothing's going to, you know, it'll all go back the way it was anyway, so who cares? But if we're going to leave, if we're going to take the option where we live with our mistakes and we move forward, then it does matter. And if it matters, I guess I'll be taking Zulf, because otherwise I would feel like a bad person. More than I already do. Oh no! I'm going even slower. That's not even funny. I don't want to go even slower. Have mercy, please.
Don't you worry, though. Once the Bastion's restored, it'll all be alright.
Yes, I know. You've been saying that for a while now. Are you serious? Even slower? Oh.
You ain't still thinking about that whole leaving the city thing, are you?
Yes, I am. Deal with it. Oh, this is gonna hurt, isn't it? I can't dodge. I can't do anything. Oh, boy. Ow. Ow, 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 ow. Shit.
Lie on my back. Clouds are making way for me. I'm coming home. Sweet home.
I see. Oh, are you kidding me? This is brutal. Okay, you guys getting the message? You gonna stop shooting me now? Thank you.
Eyes open wide.
Holy crap, there are a lot of you, though. We're back to shooting again. Fuck.
Kid's probably dealt with Zulf by now.
Yeah, I mean, you could say that, I guess.
He reminds me of myself when I was his age. I ever tell you about those days?
I don't think so. What's all the rumbling?
Hey, kid.
Yes, sir. Get up, man. Get up. You can do it. You can do it.
Get up, kid.
I'm trying. Come on.
Come on, that ain't funny. I say get up.
I mean, I was just shot full of a hell of a lot of arrows, man. Give me a break.
That's more like it.
Oh, you're all now, smashed.
Set that shard into the monument there. Then we'll talk.
Hi, guys. You're all here. Where's Rex and Zia, though? Oh, I can't use anything? All right. I guess we'll just do this, then. Do this thing.
The Bastion. It's finally finished.
Oh, it's all healed again. Yay. It's all shiny and new.
Now, there's something I want you to see.
Okay. What is it? Where is it? In the Calamity, the Tazal returned from the underground and cast toward the stars. Wow.
Welcome to the heart of the Bastion. I ain't one for long goodbyes, so here's the deal.
Yeah.
Oh, Zia and I figure you done the heavy lifting, so you get to do the honors.
What? Honors what?
We can tell you how to work this thing if you got any questions.
I have questions.
You made it.
Holy shit, she speaks.
So, let's see. You can either prevent the calamity, or stick around with me and Rex. I'd hate to be in your shoes.
She has never spoken before. Wow. Okay. Asking about the evacuation mode.
If I could be any place I wanted, I'd stay right here. We could go anywhere in the world.
I mean, people like to travel, right? And, you know, we kind of fucked this place up pretty good.
Zulf tried to talk me into joining him. I tried to talk him out of it. I guess we both failed.
Yeah, kinda. A little bit. At least you stayed, though. You know, that's good. I appreciate that.
When I finally found my people, I told them we could help. They just took me for a traitor. Glad you showed up.
Yep. Yeah, angry people can often make bad decisions.
Any moment I'd want to live again happened after the calamity, not before.
Now that's interesting. You know, I mean, her life was pretty hard, but it's definitely fascinating to me that she would want to relive moments afterwards.
Hey, kid.
What's up, Rooks?
You can undo the calamity here and now. Go on, kid. And before I forget, thank you.
So, if I choose to just take the ship and leave, are you going to get mad at me? Like, are you going to pull a Zulf on me? Because that would suck a lot.
I always wondered what the motherland was like. Not that it matters anymore.
Yeah, is the plan even still there? I mean, how far-reaching was this whole calamity shtick? Man.
Zulf only brought more ruin to the Ura. No wonder they didn't take kindly to him.
Yeah. That's what happens when you go off half-cocked. He was too angry and didn't want to learn the rest of the truth. He figured he had it all. Had the whole picture.
You've got one thing left to do. So you hang on to that badge. Besides, you earned it.
Damn right I did. I worked hard. And the pecker nest.
Don't let anything you've done get to you. You can save all those creatures here and now.
Oh, wow. Twist that knife in my heart a little bit, would you? Well, I guess it's time to make the decision. Restoration. Initiate the Bastion's restoration protocol. Caution, this process will restore to a previous world state and is irreversible. Use only as directed. Evacuation. Caution, this process will cause irreparable damage to the core receptacles, disabling the restoration protocol. Yeah, so basically just choose one or the other. So I can put the world back to the way it was and hope this never happens again, which, I mean, that's kind of a long shot. I mean, it probably just resets the game and you just can go play it again, more or less. But evacuation brings us to somewhere new, something different, and that's how you grow, and that's cool. You know, I'd like to see the next chapter of this, so I guess we're going with that. Sorry, Rux, I'm siding with with Zia.
Ooh. Oh, mother. And here I figured you'd had enough of me by now.
Nah, man. This is off to the side. Come on, get over here. You have a lot to make up for.
The calamity itself. But instead, you want to stay in a world like this.
Sure. I mean, I guess it helps if, like, it's not actually a choice I have to live with, but still.
I ain't yet put much thought in that idea. But carrying on with you here. Can't go back no more. But I suppose we could go wherever we please.
Yep. The music in this game is so awesome, though. Listen to that. Like the fucking it's like a combined form of the two songs we've heard before, I think.
And if anyone left out there, I sure would like to see the look in their faces.
Yeah, because that's Zulf's song, right?
Dock this thing right on that doorstep.
That would be cool, by the way. Be able to have like a sequel where like you can fly the Bastion around looking for survivors. Myself, that would be cool.
I'm gonna need a first mate. What do you say?
Sign me up, Captain. Oh, that's cool. Nice. Man, I haven't played this game in way too long. I love this game. And that's Bastion. So, before I just let you guys listen to the awesome music, I just wanted to say thanks for sticking through with the end of the series with me. Hope you guys enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed playing it. It's a great game with a great story and an amazing soundtrack, for sure. And I guess... Oh, featuring Logan Cunningham as the narrator. I feel like I should know who that is, but I don't, because I am oblivious. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the series, and if you did, be sure to click the like button down below. If you have any comments or questions, be sure to leave them in the comments, and I'll get back to you. And yes, in case you were wondering, one of the games I am planning to play after the No Man's Sky marathon is Transistor, which is made by the same company as did this game. It's not a sequel of any kind, unfortunately, but it's still in the same kind of style, I think, though it's more futury than Western, but I definitely look forward to playing that. Look at the squirtin' Zulf. Aw, he's fucking adorable. Hi, little guy. But yeah. So, if you want to see more videos and stick around for that Transistor series as well as No Man's Sky, then be sure to subscribe. It's always appreciated. And, of course, share the video around if you want your friends to see it. And, as always, I'll see you guys in the next video. MonsterMatt out. Have a great day.